Man, bro, I swear to God, bro. The f they got rose petals and shit in here? What the f are y'all doing? Man, women ain't man. Listen here, and I'm not saying all women ain't but let me start this by saying this. I don't even do this social media shit. Like, I usually don't go on social media. I don't post shit on there. But today, I want to help the next guy out. Because I just want to let you know, women ain't shit, man. This is from today. I'm at work. Go to work every day. I work hard every f***ing day to take care of this woman. Because I'm paying the bills. I pay for her to go to school. I take care of the kids. I put food in the house. I don't even get EBT. I don't get food stamps. I got to pay for food out my f***ing pocket. But let me show y'all this. This is what I see at work. And I don't never check the cameras. Like, I got cameras in my home. This is to protect us. I don't never check the f***ing cameras. But today, something told me to check the f***ing cameras. I don't know what told me today. God must have spoke to me. But what's done in the dark always comes to the light. And today, I'll check the cameras. This is what I see. Come on, bro. Let me show y'all what I see. Do y'all see this? Who the f*** is this? This is my girl. My girl in the red pajama. She holding his hand and shit. Bro, I don't think y'all understand how pissed I am right now. Got me f***ed up. These women ain't, man. Look at this shit, man. Coming in the This is my f***ing house. This is the house I paid for. I paid for this f***ing bills. Let her go to school and shit. Look at this shit, man. This is the shit I'm seeing at work. I'm on my lunch break. This is the shit I'm seeing at motherfucking work. How pissed off right now? She all on top of this shit, man. I'm gonna tell you, man, these women ain't shit, man. I'm giving my all into this relationship. Alright, just don't play back. I'm putting my all into this relationship. And she got a whole motherfucking in my house. Oh, these women ain't. I'm trying to tell you, a lot of these women ain't. Look at this shit, man. Girl, now they're gonna go upstairs to the fucking bedroom. Dog, I pay for that fucking dog too. She don't know I'm here, though. It's all good. She don't know I'm here, though. But I'm finna go holler. Pay for your ass, too. I pay for you, too. Don't do shit. Cheat. That's what I should do. What the f*** is this? What the f*** is this? Huh? Who the f*** is this? Who the f*** is this? Ain't no what's up, nothing. Ain't no, what the f*** is this? My wife, what the f*** is this? Ain't no come on nothing. What the f*** is you doing in my house, bro? It is the f***. It looks like it's on all on camera. You don't know I got cameras? Dummy? Man, bro, I swear to God, bro. The f***, got rose petals and shit in here? What the f*** is this? Y'all got cameras on the house and on my f***ing phone. And what's your f***? Because you're a f***ing cheater. I do everything for you. I pay the f***ing bills in this house. Do everything for your f***. You got a whole nigga in my motherfucking house. Bro, get out, bro. I will move, bro. The f*** out my freedom. Oh, you didn't know? Oh, you didn't know? Yeah, I pay everything. You my motherfucking house. Oh, you knew? Yeah. You said, oh, I'm the man of God, bro. You up. What's wrong with you, bro? Yeah, so goofy ass out. Ain't no baby sore in my ass. Get the f*** out.
Why do I have to
put my
muscles down?
Get the f*** out my house.
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bah Hashem, Yahweh Shah Bah Hashem, Recha Ha Kodash, and double honors to the elder apostles and the elders, elder bishops of Great Millstone. Honors also to you, brethren. Shalom to you, brethren. You followers of the truth, even you few sisters, and shalom to the elect. Anyway, I ran across this video called Man Caught Wife in Bed Cheating on Security Camera. So you hear the song that I put in there by The Temptations, Treat Her Like a Lady, which was actually a pretty good song. I used to like the song back in the 80s, right? But we can see where this kind of message have turned and twisted the situation. The screen name, the title, the channel's screen name is MJ Get Right. He's on Instagram or whatever. So I didn't listen too much of his commentary. I did look fast forward to the actual video. And what's disturbing about the whole video is what you've seen. But the excuse that Eve made was, it's not what it looks like. It's not what you think. Now, maybe that was just something to say because of the embarrassment. And I don't even think Eve is embarrassed. I think Eve just feels like she done got caught. Then Eve goes on to say, I'm sorry. You know, I'm sorry. Then they'll go on to say, 6 months from now, I made mistakes. Now, I know when making a mistake, you know, we all go off. We all fall short. But you're pouring a little hot water into to make some tea and it spills over. Well, that's an accident. That's kind of a mistake. But this woman brought this man into this other man's house and mistakenly fell on top of him. Then mistakenly grabbed his hand and rolled her on upstairs. First of all, mistakenly got her in the car. I mean, she picked him up, I believe, and brought her there. So anyway, and I'm looking online and I'm looking at the simples, let me say that, who are always making an excuse for Eve. And this is why Eve continues to do what they do. They continue to do what they do because there's absolutely no fear. And mainly because of the curse of the Heavenly Father put on us to where we would not have that power to be able to do what we need to do. Now, Christian churches says, throw out all the laws. And this is an example of what happens through plantation Christianity. Throw out all the laws. So anyway, I'm going to get a scripture because there's not much I can say on this video. But let me get Amos 7 and 16. Now therefore, hear thou the word of the Lord. Thou sayest, prophesy not against Israel, and drop not the word against the house of Isaac. Right? Therefore, thus saith the Lord, thy wife shall be an harlot in the city. Okay? So, this is why we get on them, man. And you know, another thing I noticed is that on the comments, all bunch of Eves come jumping in. This is just makes it look bad for us. I understand that part. You know, the ones that claim to be sincere anyway. It looks bad for us. It doesn't look right. And it's not all sisters. Even the guy on the commentary said, well, you know, it's not all women, which we know that. But when it comes to Jake, and when we do things like that, you'll never really hear them say, well, it's not all men. It's not all men. Not all men do this type of behavior. It's always Eve that gets a pass for all this kind of behavior and gets away with it. Going through things psychologically, all the simples making excuses. You know, I'm glad all the queens are like that. You Jakes are the ones set it all up. From day one, you were taught you never put your hands on a woman. I heard that. I had family members got in trouble behind that while they was in school, right? But when a woman stabs you, you know, your loved one with a pencil and tried to slice him with a blade and then you hit him back, nobody says anything about the woman should not be behaving like that. They always talk about Jake. When Jake steps up to the plate and defends himself from this kind of behavior, now Jake is the messed up one. Right? And now you got white woman, you got Eve posing as white woman, making up stories, right, to try to discredit Jake. This is all over YouTube, man. Anyway, and it says, and thy daughters and thy sons and thy daughters shall fall by the sword, right? What you see happening. Now, if this thing got out of control and this man had a gun, which he probably did, I don't know, what could have happened? he could have shot both of them. And according to the scriptures, is it correct? Right? We know the answer to that. Now, this guy may have not known. Now, you heard in the clip, the guy said, "Why didn't you tell me?" And she said, "I did tell you." So one of them are lying, you know? You know, this man's stuff is up in the house. I don't think that Jake really cared. But this Eve probably never did tell him. Pretty sure she did, but she probably didn't. And the fact is, she didn't care. But this man said, "Hey, I'll take care of the bills. I don't get EBT." And that was his pride kicking in, because nobody really cares about that. It was just the fact that this man felt like he'd done so much for the woman, for this Eve, for her to transgress on him like that. It's really hurtful. And let me say this too, man, before I move on. This guy was fortunate enough to catch this act. This probably been going on for I don't know how many years or the time they met. And this is why I'm doing this video, to message to you brothers, especially you younger brothers who get trapped up with that Eve. And you think, even some of them that claim to be Israelites, yeah, I hear stories about them too. Right? Not all the sisters. I'm just saying. You got some of them. Yeah. Just like Jake, that comes to the truth. Okay? And wicked. Why can't you have Eve coming to the truth and be wicked? But nope, that's swept under the rug. Anyway, this word harlot is to commit fornication, be a harlot, play the harlot, to be a harlot, act as a harlot, commit fornication, to commit adultery. Right? A lot, you know, there's another form of adultery to you as well, where, you know, you in the truth and Eve is telling you, yeah, why are you in that truth, and sabotaging you in the truth, trying to keep you from the truth, and, you know, trying to take your time from the truth. She's committing a desperate act, a sin against you, you know, to commit adultery, to be a cult prostitute, to be unfaithful to God, right? And a man is the woman's Lord, right? So anyway, let's go on over here to Deuteronomy. Let's go to Deuteronomy 28 and 19. "Cursed shalt thou be when thou comest in your home, and cursed shalt thou be when thou goest out of your home," right? meaning anything you put your hand to. "The Lord shall send upon thee curses and vexations and rebuke, and all thy settest thine hand unto for to do." And this is the problem with Jake. Jake believes in the super life of society. Jake believes in making it, because this is all Jake knows. I mean, this, we're put in this world, and we got tasks set in front of us that we're supposed to make it. We're supposed to be successful, but you were never meant to be successful here. First of all, as long as Eve see that man's money on that dollar bill, on that $20 bill, she will never fully respect you as a man. And you have to know that the only time that she's truly your wife is when you're there with her. When you go off to work like that Jake did, well, didn't seem to be so. She was no longer his wife, right? Although she was bound to be his wife. But in the society, nope. He thought he got a dime piece. And that's another thing. You know, for Jake, stop looking for the prettiest woman, man. The most nicest looking woman. Look for the feminine woman. Look for the soft woman. One that takes care of herself. One that will take care of you. And you take care of her. You know, do it spiritually, man. Look in the spirit. It's a spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. Those high-end ones, they all about arrogancy and prideness, man. They've been told all their life they're beautiful. They told all their life they can get somebody else. They've been told that they could change men like they change panties. And they've been doing it. And you Jakes been doing it. You know, it's in the blue pill music. Now, we know the old school music was a little bit, to me personally, was a little bit more real, because you had Eve who was susceptible to that, and would take hold and at least try and play a part in it, although Eve was still wicked. But you can see where it brought us, right? Anyway, let's go to verse 30. Let's go to verse 25. Verse 23. And thy heaven that is over thy head shall be brass, and the earth that is under thee shall be iron. The Lord shall make the rain of thy land powder of dust, and from heaven shall it come down upon thee until thou be destroyed. So when we were brought here, we took, and you had our own people said that these were great people for allowing, some of the Quakers and abolitionists were great people for allowing us to build schools, for allowing us to build churches. But it was totally against our heritage. It was under their authorization. So when we build churches, we follow Christmas, we follow Easter, we follow different gods, as the scriptures say. We didn't follow the Lord. So it doesn't matter if you claim you're going into a church and praising and doing the right thing. We wasn't following the Lord. And those schools was teaching you false information. The main thing is they didn't tell you who the hell you were. And if you knew who you were, they tried to take that away. Anyway, verse 30. Thou shalt betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with her. Thou shalt build an house, and thou shalt not dwell therein. You want to tell me that we don't fit these prophecies, man? There's no way that you could say we don't fit these prophecies. Ecclesiastes 7:26. And I find more bitter than death the woman whose heart is snares and nets. That's why the scripture says, stumble not at the beauty of a woman. And her hands is bands. Whosoever pleases the Most High shall escape from her, but the sinner shall be taken by her. Right? The sinner shall be taken by her. Now, the bitterness means a harlot's end of wickedness, a cry. Right? This is what it is, man. Whose soul is, it says, in the inner part. Okay? The heart, the mind, the spirit is all snares and nets. And you know who taught him that? Well, you already know who taught him that. You know the husband was set up to allow it to happen and to treat the little girl with extra privileges, and this is what you get out of it. Spoiled. Anyway, that's all I have on that. Shalom.